Computational fluid dynamics is an attractive approach to simulate slurry pipeline flows, since it allows gathering detailed fluid dynamic information on all components of a real-scale slurry pipeline system without incurring in the high cost, size limitations, and technical issues of laboratory tests. At the same time, computational methods are not free from disadvantages. It was previously explained that CFD models group into two main categories according to the way in which the motion of the solid phase is described. In Eulerian Lagrangian models, the trajectories of all computational particles are determined by solving the Lagrangian particle equation of motion. This approach allows gathering a lot of information at the scale of the single particle, but at the price of a high computational cost, which becomes practically unaffordable for the highly concentrated slurries encountered in hydrotransport applications. On the other hand, the computational cost of Eulerian-Eulerian models, which describe the motion of the solid phase through the solution of its own mass and momentum conservation equations, is much lower and virtually independent from the volume of solids, thus making the Eulerian-Eulerian approach the only viable option to simulate slurry pipe flows for engineering purposes. However, Eulerian-Eulerian models suffer from their dependence on constitutive equations for the solid phase and on closures for the turbulence correlations, which typically include empirical coefficients calibrated with respect to laboratory experiments, creating uncertainty in the numerical predictions. As a result, many Eulerian-Eulerian models appear to have an interpretative value, in the sense that once they have been calibrated against a given set of experiments, they allow deepening insight into the characteristics of those flow conditions. However, very few Eulerian-Eulerian models have shown predictive value, that is, proven reliability outside the calibration conditions. Apart from that, another common drawback of existing Eulerian-Eulerian models for slurry flows is that their applicability conditions are often unclear. It has already been explained that different slurry pipe flow regimes exist, namely homogeneous, pseudo-homogeneous, heterogeneous, partially stratified, and fully stratified. These regimes arise from three physical mechanisms at the basis of the slurry transport, namely the interaction between the particles and the surrounding fluid, often in the turbulent regime, the quick collisions within a cloud of particles, and the enduring contacts within a bag of packet solids. Granular Eulerian-Eulerian models have a lot of potential to account for particle-particle interactions, but at present, there does not seem to exist an Eulerian-Eulerian model capable to effectively account for all the three basic mechanisms, and therefore suitable to reproduce all the slurry pipe flow regimes. Eulerian-Eulerian models can provide useful information about the slurry flow in pipes. For instance, from the distribution of the solid volume fraction over the pipe cross-section, it is possible to extract the vertical solid volume fraction profile. From the pressure profile along the pipe axis, it is possible to estimate the hydraulic gradient, IM. Finally, also the velocity distribution of the two phases can be easily obtained. As the final step of a longer research in which Stefano Malavasi from Politecnico di Milano and Michael Malin from CHAM Limited were involved, Vaclav Matushek and I recently established an Eulerian-Eulerian model capable to simulate fully suspended flows, in which the fluid turbulence is strong enough to keep all solids suspended, and particle-particle collisions play a minor role. This model is suitable for application to pseudo-homogeneous flows dominated by particle-turbulence interactions. The model, arising as an extension to slurry flows of the IPSA of Spalding, was obtained through the double average approach, in which the Reynolds averaging is applied to all flow variables, including velocity. As a result, all conservation equations include phase diffusion fluxes, which were modeled via a gradient diffusion approximation, with diffusivity dependent on an empirical coefficient called turbulent Schmidt number for volume fractions, sigma. An eddy viscosity-based approach was adopted to model the double correlations between the fluctuating velocities of both phases, and the two-phase extension of the K-epsilon standard model was used to quantify the eddy viscosity. Another important characteristic of the model resides in the introduction of a friction parameter, mu m, which is used to calculate the deviatoric stress tensor of the solid phase, tilde tau s, through a solid viscosity mu s, and the interfacial momentum transfer term, capital tilde m, from j to k. The friction parameter, in turn, is obtained through an empirical correlation dependent upon the second coefficient called beta. Finally, the last peculiar feature of our Eulerian-Eulerian model is a wall function for the solid phase to model the mechanical friction produced by particle-wall interactions. Our Eulerian-Eulerian model has been referred to as beta-sigma model to highlight the presence of the two empirical coefficients, beta and sigma, whose values have to be obtained by experimental calibration. Provided that beta and sigma are properly set, the beta-sigma model allows accurate prediction of hydraulic gradient and vertical concentration profile of slurry pipe flows in the pseudo-homogeneous regime, and it was also successfully applied to pipe end flows. Very important, it also showed good pipe size-up scalability, in the sense that once beta and sigma have been calibrated with respect to a small pipe in a laboratory circuit, the same set of values can be used to simulate the flow of the same slurry in bigger pipes. In summary, the beta-sigma model seems to have the potential to be a useful predictive tool for engineers and designers, and research efforts are currently devoted to overcoming the limiting assumption of a fully suspended flow.